member, but you'll be in a moment, so I'll introduce our project in the meantime. Our goal in this project is to design a musical instrument, which is at the same time a play device for children. De Klankspeeltuin is an organization in Amsterdam from the Muziekgebouw aan het IJ. And they have three installations currently that are used to teach children their way around music and their way around composing music especially and making their own music. In this project we decided to, or in this week actually, we decided to work quite quickly. So we had only a small idea generation and we took an idea. We've worked that idea out and we have a semi-working prototype at the moment, which is not fully functional, but we can show it a little. We've also let our thoughts run about the technology that is used in our prototypes, the technology that we would like to use in the final prototype as it would be produced by a certain company. We don't have a client yet, but that might be so. We have two different versions of our idea that can be used in either a home or at schools and at the Klankspeeltuin. So I'll elaborate on that later. I think I will start with explaining my concept, since my colleague is here now. We have devised a cube, and this cube you can record a sound on each side of the cube. So a child can take this cube home or to an environment that he likes, to the forest. He can record different sounds on it and then later he can edit those sounds on this board. So let's see. I don't know if you can hear it, but okay, I'll let it hear here. I'm first going to show you the different sounds that we recorded. First sound. Now let's suppose that the sound is on this side of the cube. Normally I could let you hear the sound from the cube, but it's failing me a little bit right now. A child can go to the board, can place the cube on line, in this case the second line. And when you place the cube on the line, the sample that is inside the box swaps over by Bluetooth to the board and the sample is now shown inside the board. So the sound that you just hear on the computer is now inside my board on the second line. And at the same time you can see the length of the sample. So the sample I recorded this time on side two was quite long and it fills the entire board in one time. The second sound, let's see if we can get that one out. Okay, we can. Slower, thus made it longer. But now I thought, well, no, I don't like this quite, I want to slide it back. So I make the sample shorter again to its original length. There I keep it for now. So that's my second sample. The third sample that I want to put into my board is, oh, I can't show that on the cube actually. Just at its original length. But I want to hear the sample again in my song, so I put it again here. Oh, sorry, a little bit over. And I decide that I want to have it a little bit shorter, so I move my cube a bit to the left. And I want to do that again. So I place it again here.
Make it makkelijker voor jezelf.
Oh, and I've made it short at the same time. My colleague is a little bit lazy at the moment. So I've put it one time at its original length. I started the sample again before the end of the first sample, but I made it a bit shorter and I did that again. The fourth sound is this one. Okay, I'm going to place that on the bottom line. And I want to have that sound four times in my song. So that's one, two, three, and four. Then I have, maybe I can let it play from this side. No, it won't. Okay. Ah, it's a bit of a pity that it didn't work. So this could be like my mother walking down the room or something like that. And I'm going to place that sound here. And first I'm going to make it a little bit shorter. So I have a shortened version, which is quicker. I'm going to place it one time in its original length, right here. Okay? The last sound is something a little bit more funny that I thought of. and I'm going to place that two times at the end of my song. So that's here. And here. Okay. Now I've made my own composition of the sounds that I recorded. And I can let you hear what this composition would sound like. Just the way I wanted on the board. I've lengthened it, I've shortened it, and this is exactly the song I wanted to make. Now a little bit about the background of the concept. We want to teach children to make their own compositions, and what we found in the original devices at the Klangspieltuin was often that the relationship between what the children were doing and what they heard back from the device was not very logical. There was like a sheet of paper and you could put a pen on it, and when you put the pen in the left top corner, you would hear a very wee 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 sound like that. When you put it somewhere else, you had an entirely different sound. But you just put the pen on a piece of paper, so there was no relationship between what you were doing and what you were getting out of it. So that's why we decided that the children should use their own samples. They should record their own sounds that they wanted to use. And in this way, they can get a clear picture in their mind of what happens to the sounds when they combine them and when they shorten them or stretch them out over the board. The technology that we want to use, there need to be recording devices inside this box. The box has at the edges pressure sensors, so that when you push them on the board, the board will know which side of the cube is pressed onto the board. The communication from the box to the board is done via Bluetooth, because you have to send over which side is pushing the board, and you have sent over the music samples. The board has two boxes on the side that can play the sound. It has a play button, and it has an eraser. We didn't build it the eraser, but it would be like a school board, like a, how do you call it, a chalkboard, whiteboard, chalkboard, with an eraser, as would a normal chalkboard have. And with the eraser, you can also erase little pieces of the composition and change them again. The board would be bought by, for example, schools or by the Klangspieltuin. And it would cost approximately 500 euros when it's in production. We have, yes? the cubes are a lot more inexpensive because, well, we could imagine that cubes get lost or children mash up cubes or try to destroy them or something like that. So the cubes would only be like 5 euros. And why the cost could be so low is because this project would receive sponsoring from the music world, but also from the government. So in that way, oh, and from Fisher Price, we thought the Fisher Price would be a good client to make this board. So in that way, you can keep the cubes inexpensive, and you can put the costs mainly in the board.